In this video, we're going to look at the view transaction functions in order entry. So you go to order entry, all view transactions. Again, I know I keep saying this, but just like in purchasing, you click view transactions. It'll list all the transactions that you have available in order entry. You can see which ones need to be converted, what type they are, contracts, change orders, invoices, things of that nature. You can edit, you can view, see the document number, reference number, who the customer are, currency, dates. If they're closed, converted, or partially converted, pending mean they haven't been converted at all. And sometimes submitted if, well, scratch that, back it up. Order entry would not have submitted because you don't have approvals in order entry. You have print and email, which of course we'll just print and do a print and or email of that specific invoice without any modifications. Tells you if it's a sales contract or not. I don't know. I've never used that. And you can, if you have configuration set correctly, you can delete a sales order if it has not been converted over to AR, and if, especially if it has not been paid. Been paid, you can forget it. You're not deleting it. I don't care what you do. So you can do your views here. But then you can also change. I didn't mention this before. I know I mentioned it way, way back. You can change how this looks. I come up here to manage views. You can do a create new or save as, and then do a edit, a create new. You have, this is everything you could show on that one screen. That's a lot. And what happens, the neat thing about these custom views, that's what they're called, is custom views, is you can kind of create a pseudo report, a faux report out of this. So you can put a lot of information out there and create a report. This would apply to purchasing, accounts receivable, payable, GL, all of it. If you have all and manage views on a screen, you can create a different view, which is kind of nice.